Hello, person I just met.
Hello there. So, what do you do?
Me? Oh, I'm an online video creator. I create videos for YouTube and I love it.
No, but like, what do you do for your job?
Oh, no, like that is my job.
Well, how do you make money?
Stump Kitchen, gluten-free, vegan, eats stumptastic treats.
Hello and welcome to Stump Kitchen. Today we're going to talk about one of the most common questions that I think all online video creators who do it for their job get every day. I don't know why people think that it's okay to ask how people make money. Like, it's kind of not their business and it's kind of personal. I think it comes from this root of assuming that people who are doing online video creation or going out on a limb and becoming entrepreneurs and following their passion, that they're not gonna make it and they're not gonna make any money and be able to survive, which is like a pretty sad narrative. How do you make money? This is a question I get all of the time. This is a whole nother video, but I think that unfortunately in this capitalist society, people expect you to have and value jobs that start at 9, end at 5, have benefits, security, have a salary. That's like the ultimate goal. And that everything else is scary or unpredictable or not desirable. And I mean, like, for some people, those jobs are great. I used to have them. I had many jobs leading up to Stump Kitchen. I worked at Tim Hortons. I delivered papers. I also had some really high stress, intense, and awesome jobs at a university and at a library. And eventually I got to the point where creating videos and doing Stump Kitchen was the only thing that gave my heart joy, and it was the only thing that I felt I could wake up to do every day. And so then I worked really damn hard to make sure that I could do it every day and that it could be my job. And I'll tell you how I did it. And of course, just a disclaimer, this is all stuff that I've done. This is not a video about how to make money as a content creator. These are things that have worked for me that I get asked about all of the time, and so I thought it would be good to make a video about it to answer those questions and to give a little bit more insight into the inner workings of a YouTube video creator career. So I think the first thing that was the most important thing for me when I started my Stump Kitchen adventure, journey, whatever this is, was realizing that creating videos and doing Stump Kitchen and working with guests, meeting other people with limb differences, talking about my stump and my body and using my limbs in the kitchen and all the things that Stump Kitchen embodies, I realized that was exactly what I needed to be doing. It was the thing that was fulfilling me. It became my passion, something that I looked forward to when I woke up in the morning. It was the first thing that I wanted to do, and it was the last thing I thought about before going to bed. It was just like a couple weeks span. I had made my first video. I put it out there kind of just for fun and for me, and people loved it. They really, really grabbed onto it, and the comments I was getting were beyond anything I could have imagined. Pardon me. I also realized that doing the video, creating the video, I was getting just so much joy out of it. And so I thought, well, maybe we'll make another one. Maybe I'll make this a regular thing. And I did. I committed to that regular posting schedule. I mean, as regular as I can be. I'm not the most regular. I started making videos once a week. And I was doing this while I was working a really intense full-time job. And I mean, the way that I eventually transitioned into doing Stump Kitchen full-time and leaving my job, etc. That's like a whole nother video because there was so much happening at the time. I got to the point where I was making videos, people were loving them, I was loving them, most importantly. It was a beautiful tool of like self-love and fun. It was a creative endeavor and it was forcing me to learn new skills like editing and filming and cooking, all of these great things. That, along with many other factors in my life, when my contract was up, I decided to leave my job and go after my dream, which was to make Stump Kitchen my full-time job. I'll tell you how I did that in a second, but people always ask me, like, weren't you terrified to leave that job, to leave that security? And my answer is always no. I wasn't scared because I knew I was doing something that I was meant to be doing, and I knew that I was going after something that was the only thing that I knew I could do at the time. Coming back to my original reason for telling you this story is that is the ultimate number one for making it as a content creator, for me anyway, was figuring out that it was the only thing that I could be doing. It was the only thing that fulfilled me, and it just felt right. And maybe not everyone that creates videos online has that passion and that drive. I don't really know, but I do know that for me, having that deep desire and deep love and knowing that it was the right thing to do made it a very easy decision to jump out of my job and go after my dream. So that was the first very important thing. Now to the money part. Currently, I have a partner. I don't have any children at the moment. I don't have a lot of debt. I generally have pretty good spending habits. I'm pretty good at saving. When I made the decision to leave my job and do Stump Kitchen full-time, I had a pretty good outlook on my finances in general. And so those financial skills that I learned early in my life have really helped me because I'm able to take a bit more risks with my job. The risk alone of just like leaving a full-time job and going into something that started with absolutely no income, I felt okay doing that. And I don't think that's always the case. I don't think it's always something that people need to have. I honestly don't know because, like I said, I'm just telling you what has worked for me. I think that people can do it in a lot of different ways. But for me, when I left my job, I had been able to be putting money away for savings. I've always been kind of saving throughout my life, not really knowing what for. I've been privileged enough to be able to kind of have a bit of a buffer so that if something happened to me or if I needed to move or if I did get fired or lose my job, I would be okay for a little while. So because I had a little cushion, I was able to leave my job and go into a situation where I had absolutely no income. I think I had about 6 months worth of savings to live on before I ran out and needed to be making money immediately. So that's how I did the first leap. And then I got into Patreon. Now Patreon, as many of you probably know, it's an awesome kind of like crowdfunding situation where people can donate a certain amount, per month to different creators of all different kinds to support their work and tell them that they really appreciate what they're doing. So I actually had a couple friends tell me about Patreon, which was amazing. Did some research right away, did a whole bunch of reading. I looked at other people who had Patreon sites, did a bunch of research, and learned almost everything that I could about it. And then I just put my head down and I got to work. I made a Patreon site, I made a video, the content of my site and my different reward tiers, and then I reached out to people all over the world, from family to friends to new people that I hadn't met yet, and telling them about Stump Kitchen and inviting them to come on this journey with me and become a patron. And people also ask me, like, wasn't that hard? Like, isn't it hard asking for money? And it's like, yeah, it's terribly hard asking people for money, but I think because I had already established that Stump Kitchen was a huge passion project and was exactly what I knew I needed to be doing with my life, and I knew the value of it. Like, I knew that it offered people a lot of stuff that was really awesome, and I could see the benefits of it for kids and families and me and people all over the world. So because I kind of had that understanding of what I was doing, it was a lot easier to invite people in and ask them to become patrons. That is another very key part. If you're a creator of some kind and you're gonna go on Patreon, I think believing what you do, believing in what you do is the most important part, because then when you are reaching out to the public or you're asking folks to join on as a patron or you're making posts about your work, you're doing it from a true place of belief in yourself and belief in the value of your work, and people are gonna see that. They're gonna be like, yes. I do think though, like at the very, very first, I was really nervous because it was like a new thing. Like, I really had to switch gears from just like doing a job, getting a paycheck, blah, 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 blah. But now I was like putting myself out there completely. Like, my job was me. It was me and my videos and my own self-promotion and my own self-worth and my own putting myself out there, all that stuff. It was a lot, but it was really, really awesome and worth it. And I think the other thing that was really important for me to be able to start Patreon was the fact that when I did, it had already been a year since I started Stump Kitchen. So I already had a year under my belt. I had a small and mighty, beautifully dedicated audience that knew my work, they could trust it, they enjoyed it, they found different things in it that spoke to them that they could kind of grab onto and be like, yeah, this is cool. When I reached out to folks to say, hey, I'm on Patreon, would you like to support me on my journey? They were like, yeah, I know you, I like your work, I know what you're doing. Had I started Patreon at the very beginning of STEM Kitchen, when I just first started creating videos, I don't think it would have been nearly as successful. If you're gonna use Patreon as a platform, I think having some time where your videos or your art or your creations or whatever you're doing has had some time to build an audience, to build that trust, it's a lot easier to take it the next step and ask people to come on the Patreon adventure with you. The other thing with Patreon is that in and of itself was a full-time job. I think I started it about 2 months, 1 or 2 months after I left my other full-time job. I think it took about three almost full-time months. Also creating videos for STEM Kitchen still, of course, but like most of my time was spent doing Patreon, creating messaging, reaching out to people individually, sending out little invitations or sending out patron perks, updating my page, and it took a lot of time. Like I knew I had to dedicate many, many weeks, months in fact, to make it successful. And I knew that I didn't want to go halfway. Like I wanted to go all the way in or nothing, because I knew that if I didn't put everything that I had into this Patreon project, that I would regret it later. And that if it failed, then I was the only one to blame. Pardon me. So I just went right in there. It was really hard and really, really fun. It was hard to get no traction, but it was really awesome when somebody was like, yeah, of course I'll come on this journey with you. That would be amazing. And I could do a whole nother video on just like how to do Patreon or like what's worked for me. If you have any questions or comments around Patreon, or if you're on it and like you can tell me what's worked for you and what hasn't. And there's a lot that I'm not saying here because it would be a whole nother video. So feel free to reach out about that. I love talking about it. Also, as you probably guessed, Patreon is an ongoing job, so you constantly have to be updating your page and talking with your patrons and adding the perks. But once you get that first two or three like really intense months out of the way, then it's just like upkeep and it's a lot easier to manage. And when you get a new patron, you automatically know what to do. You know what perks they're gonna get. It's a lot easier once you get it all established. On to the next thing. Because Patreon is a big chunk of my income, but not all of my income, the next thing that's worked for me for making money as a content creator is diversifying my income. So that means I do a lot of other different things to help supplement my income so I can buy really nice knives. But seriously though, all I spend my money on are kitchen utensils and like equipment and food. That's about it. So here's the thing about diversifying your income. Like in the first maybe year that I was on Patreon and I was doing other things to supplement my income, like Patreon, it didn't grow to where it is now until now. Like it took 3 years to get to where it is now, and it's kind of hit a beautiful plateau and it's slowly growing, and then it's also slowly falling because, like, you know, patrons come and go and that's the reality of it. Yeah, it took a while to get to where it is now, and so I had to do other jobs to kind of make ends meet. So what did I do at first? Okay, because that growth took a little while, I was lucky enough, like I said before, to have some savings that I was able to supplement my income with and survive on. Once those kind of dried out, Patreon had grown a little bit, but I needed more income. Other things that I currently do include working very part-time at a lovely local cafe, usually about one day a week. Also, I do cooking lessons. So I go to people's houses and I do birthday parties and I do gluten-free and vegan cooking, mostly with kids, but also with adults too. Personalized, fun cooking lessons. And I love that because it takes a lot of what I already do with STEM Kitchen, like it's very much on brand, and it also is tied to education. Like I have an education degree too, in fact. Bringing that aspect into my job has been such a great fit and it has just felt really, really natural. I also do catering gigs sometimes. Maybe like 4 or 5 times a year, I'll do like a pretty major catering gig. I've done a wedding, I've done a huge community dinner. I did a wake for a lovely gentleman who had just recently become vegan, and his family found me and said, would you cater this wake? And I was like, absolutely. Being able to create food, vegan and gluten-free food, for a large amount of people in those ways has been really, really awesome. And I don't do it often, but it is something I do once in a while, and it helps to supplement my income too. And the other thing I do, and I think this is like what perhaps a lot of content creators are able to do at some point in their career, is public speaking. So I get asked to do workshops, speaking gigs. I travel, not a lot, but like a little bit. I go to different places and I speak to groups. I do limbs-on workshops with staff, you know, all that kind of stuff. I get to show what I do to the entire world. So it's more out there, and therefore there's more possibilities for people to see me and to invite me to be a speaker or a workshop presenter for their own things and then pay me money. So that's a nice advantage of being a public content creator. What else do I do? Oh yeah, the other thing I do, which is not related to Stump Kitchen at all, but it is highly related to another huge life passion. I'm a big choir nerd. I conduct a ukulele choir on the weekends, and that provides a modest income as well. And I love it so much. It's just the absolute best. And I think it's like really important to have an activity or a job or something small that you can do like once a week that has nothing to do with your main career. It's really cool to have, like for me, I sing in choir one night a week, and then I do the ukulele choir on the weekend. And those two things are just like purely for me. They're not related to like Stump Kitchen. I love it. I can just go and just kind of be a huge choir nerd and sing to my heart's content or play to my heart's content. Yeah, I'm just very lucky to have those things in my life. I think one more thing that I'll say, and perhaps the last thing I'll say, is when I started out and Patreon was slowly growing, but I knew that I needed more income to survive, I thought about, okay, well, maybe I'll do like a part-time job doing blah, 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 like going into an office and getting a job or whatever. And I thought about that really strongly because I was like nervous that maybe Patreon wouldn't grow, maybe I wouldn't get other opportunities, like just kind of trying to cover my bases. Thinking about that made my soul hurt, and I talked to my partner quite a bit about it, and she helped me hash out the fact that for me to be able to be really like happy and grounded in what I'm doing, it really needed to be related to my ultimate goal, which is Stump Kitchen. And so that slowly helped me narrow what I do for other sources of income, like the cooking classes, such a huge connection. It's absolutely perfect. It's on brand. I get to wear my Stump Kitchen apron. I get to do exactly what I do in my videos, but in someone's house with their kids or with their family. And it's so much fun. I think that my biggest piece of advice would be keep it on brand. Keep it like in line with what you're already doing, so your energy doesn't get sucked into places that you don't really want it to go, because then you're going to have less energy for what you want to do. That idea has really helped me say no to a lot of opportunities that have come up, and it's also helped me say yes to things that really feel right for me. I guess I'll also say that like you don't have to be a huge, you know, million subscriber YouTube channel to survive as a content creator. I think Stump Kitchen has just under 4,000 subscribers. If you just went on that, there's no, like my ad revenue monthly is like $17, which is lovely. I guess that's another way that my income is supplemented. Like I make about $12 to $17 a month on YouTube itself. The actual YouTube platform is like probably the lowest portion of my income, but it's there. I mean, $17 is nothing to scoff at. If that's the only thing I was judging my income on, or I think that's the assumption that people have, is like, oh, you're on YouTube, so you must have a million subscribers to be able to survive. It's like, actually, no. I do all these other things that I talked about earlier in the video. Maybe that's also a good message, like, to remember if you are a smaller content creator. Like, just remember that the number of views you have and the number of subscribers and the number of hits does not define your worth as a creator. Those hits, those subscribers, those comments, those people that are watching you, they're there for a reason. They're there for you and for what you're putting out there, no matter how big or small your audience is. And yeah, maybe your audience will grow and maybe it won't. Maybe it'll just exist as this beautiful amount that it is right now. My audience has been growing slowly but surely. But it's constantly been like this beautiful, small but mighty audience that I just love so, so much. And quite honestly, if nothing changed in that department, I would be totally okay with that. Also because like I am at the point now where I can respond to every single comment and I can pretty much get back to almost everyone that reaches out and messages me. And I think if I got too much bigger, I would lose that ability. But if it does grow and change, then I hope I can do my best to stay as engaged as possible. Wow, okay, that was a lot of honesty. I don't think I've had this type of like financial honest discussion online before. So I hope this was entertaining or valuable. Let me know down below. I would love to know your thoughts, other things that you've done that's worked for you or other questions that you might have. Just remember that the question, so how do you make money? It's not a bad question, but it can definitely make people a little uncomfortable, especially when I have to explain how I make money to someone. I mean, if I choose to, I don't have to tell anyone, but if I choose to explain it, I have to tell you everything that I just told you in this video. It's a long process. It's not an easy process. I think as a society and as a culture, we can like start to learn how to get a little bit better at understanding that content creators exist and that there are multiple ways to make money and survive as humans and creators and workers on this planet. We don't all have to fit the mold that capitalism tells us should be the way that people work. So let's just remember that and value that. It's really cool that humans find their own unique ways for survival, doing the stuff that they love. Thanks for sticking around for this weird video. I just really wanted to make it. Thanks for being here. If you haven't already, I would love it if you subscribe to STEM Kitchen. You can also support me on Patreon, as you now know. We'll see you next time on STEM Kitchen. Bye!